Hello, what I am going to tell you about today is what we call as map projections. Now, when you talk about projections, why are we calling it projection? Because the Earth is a three-dimensional surface. Of course, you have to assume the Earth is three-dimensional. So, when we are creating a map, when we are making a map, what we are doing is basically the three-dimensional surface is being converted into a two-dimensional map, your sheet of paper. This is a two-dimensional sheet of paper and you are making your map here. Now, Earth is three-dimensional. The paper, the sheet of paper which we have is two-dimensional, right? Now, what we have to do is to make a projection of the Earth's surface into this sheet of paper. Now, how are we going to do this? Well, let us first of all assume that this is a sheet of paper and this is a sheet of photographic paper, right? This is coated with silver bromide and all that. And let us assume that we have a cone like this. So we make a helical cone like this. Okay, a simple cone like this. Right, and we put our Earth. We put our Earth inside, and there you are. Okay, for the northern hemisphere, it's like this. For the southern hemisphere, it's like this. All right. So we put our Earth inside. Okay. Now let us assume that our Earth is completely made of glass with certain artifacts and all that, and there is a source of light placed at the center of the Earth. Okay, very good. Source of light at the center of the Earth, and this is a very strong source of light, and it is like the flash in your camera. Okay, so what happens here is you place it here inside, place the cone over it, and then what you do specifically is you switch on the flash. As soon as you click, what actually happens is all the objects lie on this particular photographic paper. All the objects are projected onto this photographic paper, and as soon as you open this, you will get a map of the world. Now this is called a conical projection. This is a conical projection. Okay. Now if you can assume things with a cone, why can't you assume things with a cylinder? Right. So if you use a cylinder like this, okay, you take the cylinder. This is a cylinder, right? Okay. And you place the word Earth inside this particular cylinder. Again, you switch on the source of light. And then what will happen is, basically, you will get a cylindrical projection when you open the cylinder. Now, the problem with the cylindrical projection is, look, if this is the top of the cylinder, the northern hemisphere is missing, right? In the conical projection, the northern hemisphere is like this. The cylindrical projection, the northern hemisphere is missing, completely missing here, right? The cylindrical projection is there, this. So, in order to have the cylinder project the Arctic areas or the Antarctic areas, we can make the projection like this. We can place a sheet of paper over the Earth like this, and then we can have a projection like this. This will be known as the azimuthal projection. So there are three categories of projections. One is called the conical projection, where the projecting surface is a cone. We have a cylindrical projection, where the projecting surface is a cylinder. And we have the azimuthal projection, where the projecting surface is a plane, the azimuthal projection. So in the azimuthal projection case, we are orienting the plane on the top of the Earth's surface, or at the bottom of the Earth's surface, like this or like this. Alright. Now, people might argue, look, if you place a cylinder like this, it might be a possibility that, okay, America is missing, the Arctic areas are missing here. So what you do is, instead of putting the cylinder like this, you put the cylinder like this. Yes, you can do that. This is called a transverse cylindrical projection. If you put the cylinder like this, this is the transverse cylindrical projection. But again, there will be a problem. What's the problem? that if you say, suppose for example, you are trying to make a map of India. So India is here, suppose India is here. Okay, now America is somewhere here. America goes missing. Now here's the problem. So now this cylinder is rotated every 6 degrees. So we rotate the cylinder every 6 degrees of longitude. All right, so this is for India, this is the orientation for India, Aurangabad maybe. Every 6 degree, okay, from here to here to here to here, we create zones of 6 degrees each. So for example, we start from -180 degrees, or for example 180 degrees west to 174 degrees west. Alright, again, so 180 degrees west to 174 degrees west is the first zone. Again, from 174 degrees west to 174 minus 6 168 degrees west, right, that is the second zone. So in this way we create zones. So in all there are 60 such zones, and these are called the universal transverse Mercator zone. And this is one of the very popular methods of projecting Earth surface into the sheet of paper. Now the problem is, what exactly are we projecting? Now you need a mathematical surface to be projected onto the Earth surface. Okay, when you are needing a mathematical surface to be projected into this particular surface, a sheet of the paper, so that mathematical surface is known as a spheroid. So what's a spheroid? It's basically a mathematical expression for an ellipsoid with a particular eccentricity and flatness and semi-major axis. So A and 1 upon F are the parameters of a spheroid. We'll talk about the spheroid somewhere in the spheroid and the datum in another piece of lecture.